केस लॉ ऑफ हिंदूज लॉ, हिंदू लॉ, जनरल प्रिंसिपल। गुरुनाथ कमलाबाई 1951। सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी रूल ऑफ हिंदू लॉ द कोर्ट्स हैव अथॉरिटी टू डिसाइड केसेस ऑन प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इक्विटी, जस्टिस, गुड कॉन्सेंस। हाउएवर such decision must not be inconsistent with the doctrine of theory of Hindu law. Chandrasekhar versus Kullan Dilwira, AIR 1963. Supreme Court held that any person who is a Hindu, Buddhist, Jain, Sikh by religion, if a Hindu is A, he practices, professes and follow of any of these religions, and B, he remain a Hindu even if he does not practice, profess and follow the tenets of any of these religion, a person does not cease to be Hindu if he becomes atheist or disinterest or diverts from the central doctrine of Hinduism and lapse from orthodox practice the Hindu religion or adopts Western way of life. Pirumal versus Punnu Swami, AIR 1971. A non-Hindu will become a Hindu by conversion in the following circumstances. First, if he undergo the formal ceremony of conversion or reconversion prescribed by the caste or community to which he is converted or reconverted, if he express a bona fide intention to become a Hindu, accompanied by the conduct unequivocal expressing that intention coupled with the acceptance of him as a member of community into the fold of which he was ushered in. Surajmani Silla Kunjar versus Durga Charan Hansada, AIR 2001. In the light of Section 2, Clause 2 of Hindu Marriage Act, scheduled tribes could be brought under the purview of our Act if a notification is issued to the effect. In a court case, they would be governed by custom, and such cause have to be proved by clear evidence. Harichandra Srinivas Mangonokar versus Sunada, AIR 2001. The object and purpose of the act is to maintain a material relationship between the spouse and not to encourage snapping on the such relationship. Condition of marriage, void and voidable marriage. Yamunabai versus Antarao, AIR 1988. Supreme Court held that a bigamous marriage, the second wife has no status of a wife because of second marriage is null and void. Priya Bala versus Sudarshan Chandra, AIR 1971. Supreme Court held that the prosecution should establish the second marriage was solemnized and a mere admission of the accused that he conducted second marriage is not enough. Sarla Mugdal versus Union of India, Lily Thomas versus Union of India 2006. Supreme Court held that there was no automatic dissolution of marriage by apostrophe of the spouse to another religion. The second marriage of a Hindu apostrophe to Islam during sustenance of the first marriage in the violation of the provision of Hindu Marriage Act. The decision in Sarla Mudgal case was reviewed in the Lily Thomas case. The court held that the marriage solemnized according to the one personal law cannot be dissolved according to another personal law because the change in the religion of the parties. Bhanu Rao versus State of Maharashtra, AIR 1965. Supreme Court held that unless marriage is celebrated or performed or with proper ceremony in due form, it cannot be said to have been solemnized. Seema versus Aswani Kumar, AIR 2006. Supreme Court ordered the compulsory registration of marriage, irrespective of religion. It directed the central and the state government to make relevant rules to this effect. Gullipalli Suraiya Rai versus Banduru Pawani, 2009. Section 5 make it clear that a marriage may be solemnized between any two Hindu if the condition contained is a said section were fulfilled. The uses of the word expression may in the opening line of the Section 5 does not make the provision of Section 5 optional. On the other hand, it is positive terms, indicates that a marriage can be solemnized between two Hindus if the conditions indicated were fulfilled. In other words, in the event of the condition remain unfulfilled, a marriage between two Hindus could not be solemnized. Rathamma versus Sujatamma, 15-11-2019, decided. Supreme Court observed that mere registration of an agreement of a marriage is not sufficient to prove marriage. Bau Rao Shankar Lokhande versus State of Maharashtra. For the proper solemnization of marriage, it must be celebrated and performed with the proper ceremony and due form. Proper solemnization of marriage is an essential to constitute bigamy. Restitution of conjugal right and judicial separation and divorce. Saroj Rani versus Sudarshan Kumar, AIR 1984, Supreme Court 1562. Supreme Court held that the constitutionality of the Section 9 conjugal right is inherent in the institution of marriage. Section 9 only codifies the pre-existing law. The provision of the section reasonable excuse is built in the safeguard against the misuse of Section 9. Russell versus Russell, 1897. The term cruelty was defined for the first time. The court held that cruelty is a conduct of such character as to have caused danger to the life, limb, or head, bodily or mentally, or give a risk to the reasonable apprehension of the conduct. Dastane versus Dastane, 1975, SCC 326. Supreme Court held that cruelty is a conduct which causes a reasonable apprehension that it is harmful and injurious for one spouse to live with another. Sobha Rani versus Madhukar Reddy, AIR 1988. Supreme Court held that demand of a dowry is also constitute cruelty. Savitri Pandey versus Prem Chand Pandey, AIR 2002, Supreme Court 519. The party seeking divorce on the ground of desertion is required to show that he or she is not taking advantage of his own wrong. Ram Naren Gupta versus Srimati Rameswari Gupta, AIR 1988, Supreme Court 2260. Supreme Court held that a decree of the mental disorder must be such that a spouse seeking relief cannot be reasonable be expected to live with one another. Amar Deep Singh versus Harvin Kaur, 2007. Supreme Court 1746. Supreme Court held that the period of 6 months mentioned in Section 13(b)(2) was not mandatory but discretionary. It was open to the court to exercise the discretion of the fact circumstances of each case where there was no possibility of the party to resume cohabitation after extinguishing all the effort of the mediation and conciliation. Digvijay Singh versus Pratap Kumari, AIR 1970, Supreme Court 137. Legal meaning of impotency is a physical or mental condition which makes consummation of marriage practically impossible. R. Lakshmi Narayan versus Santhi, AIR 2001, Supreme Court 2110. the brand of a person as unfit for a marriage and procreation on account of mental disorder is need to be established that the ailment suffered by her is a such a nature and extent that it is impossible for her to lead the normal married. The standard of proof is strict. T. Sritha versus T. V. Subhaya. Subha. AIR 1983, AP 356. Andhra Pradesh High Court held that Section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act is unconstitutional as it violates the right of privacy and human dignity granted by Article 21. Saroj Rani versus Sudarshan Kumar, AIR 1984, Supreme Court 1562. Supreme Court held that constitutionality of Section 9 of Hindu Marriage Act. Ravi Kumar versus Jamui Devi, Jalmui Devi, 2010. Cruelty has to be judged, taking into account entire fact and circumstances of the case. There is no predetermination formula. In matrimonial relationship, cruelty means absence of the mutual respect and understanding between the spouse, in which the embitters relationship. Silence in some situation may also amount to cruelty. Shobha Rani versus M. Reddy, AIR 1988. When the court is confronted with the question of cruelty, it can examine two things. First, nature of the conduct complained of. Second, it implicated the compelling spouse. In certain cases, impact need not to be considered because conduct itself is so bad. The concept of cruelty has been viewed from the point of view of way of life, economy, and the social condition of the party. B. Bhagat versus D. Bhagat, AIR 1994, Supreme Court 710. Mental cruelty can be broadly defined into the conduct which inflicted upon the other party such mental pain and suffering as it would be make impossible for other party to live with the other. Mental cruelty make a such nature that parties cannot be reasonably be expected to live together. Parveen Mehta versus Indra Jeet Mehta, 2002, Supreme Court 706. Mental cruelty of the state of mind and feeling with one of the spouse due to the behavior and behavioral pattern by the other. Mental cruelty is difficult to establish from the direct evidence. It is a matter of inference to be drawn from the fact and circumstances of the case. Vijay Kumar Ramchandra Behta versus Neela Vijay Kumar Behta, AIR 2003, Supreme Court 2462. Character assassination during the divorce petition amount to cruelty. Naveen Kohli versus Neelu Kohli, 2006, Supreme Court 558. Irrevocable breakdown of marriage amount to cruelty. Suman Kanpur versus Sudhir Kanpur, AIR 2019, Supreme Court 589. Mensrea is not necessary element in the cruelty. The concept of legal cruelty change according to the advancement of social concept and standard of living. Bipin Chandra versus Prabhavati, AIR 1957, Supreme Court 1976. There can be no discretion without animus dissidendi. It has been proved that dissenting spouse precedent in the intention to desert throughout the statutory period of 2 years. Manish Goyal versus Rohini Goyal, AIR 2010, Supreme Court 1099. Divorce on the ground of irrevocable breakdown of marriage could be granted by it under Article 142 of the Constitution. Harichand Srinivas Mangokar versus Sunadaya, AIR 2001, Supreme Court 1258. Petitioner does not have vested right to get into the relief of decree and divorce merely to show that the ground is support of the relief sought exists. it commits legal to immoral act and cannot be secure relief in the matrimonial matters. Chand Dhawan versus Jawahar Dhawan, Jawaharlal Dhawan, 1993 Supreme Court 406. Supreme Court held that the phrase passing any decree under Section 25 indicate that an order to permanent alimony can only be made when the decree is passed, granting any substantive relief under the Act and not where the main petition is dismissed or withdrawn. Supreme Court has made it clear that when the marriage is substancing, Section 18 of Hindu Marriage Act will be applied, and if the marriage is not subsisting, Section 25 of Hindu Marriage Act will apply. Ramesh Chand Daga versus Rameshwari Daga, AIR 2005, Supreme Court 422. Supreme Court held that spouse of a null and void union entered into during pendency of the early marriage is entitled to maintain on passing of the decree of nullity. Basa V. Rapaiya versus Guru Basamaya, 2005, Supreme Court, SCC 290. Supreme Court held that on adoption, adopts gets transplanted in the adopting family with the same right as the natural born of the son. Adopted son became the co-partner in the joint Hindi family property after serving all of its ties with the natural family. Gurudas versus Ras Rajan, 2006. Performance of the Dattak home is not initial and valid of the adoption according to Section 11, Clause 4, Proviso. Even when Dattak home is performed, the adoption should be taken to have been made when the actual giving and taking had been placed, and not when the religious ceremony has been performed. Guardianship. Geeta Harihar versus RBI, 1999. Supreme Court held that the word after in Section 6A cannot be interpreted to mean after the life of father. The word after that meaning in absence of, after the father is absent of the wholly indifferent to the affair of the minor, then mother will become the natural guardian of the minor. Mohini versus Virendra Kumar, 1977. Supreme Court has held that the controlling consideration in dealing with the custody of the children is the welfare of the minor and not to the rights of the parent. Sumidha Nagpal versus State of Delhi, 2000. Supreme Court held that the father's right to custody of the children is neither absolute nor indefeasible one. Welfare of the children is paramount in importance. Gaurav Nagpal versus Sumidha Nagpal, 2009. In determining the question as to why should be given custody of the minor child, the paramount consideration is the welfare of the child, not the rights of the parent under the statutes for the time being in force. Padmaja Sharma versus Ratanlal Sharma, AIA 2000. It is much obligation that a father to maintain a minor child that of the mother. If both of them are working, they are bound to contribute the maintenance of their children in the proportion of their salary. Joint family property and co-partner. Nopaiya Investment Private Limited versus Santukh Singh, Hindu Undivided Family, 2009. If the Karta of Hindu Undivided Family was away in the remote place, in this case a foreign country, and his return within the reasonable time was unlikely, a junior members of Hindu Undivided Family could act as a Karta of the family. Asruhnoor Singh versus Harpal Kaur and others. Supreme Court held that the rule under Mitakshara law that whenever a male ancestral inherit the property from any of his parent ancestral up to 3 degree and above him, then the male legal heir up to the 3 degree below him would get equal rights of the co-partner in the property will apply in the case of succession which opened before the Hindu Succession Act. Govind Bhai, Chote Bhai Patel and others versus Patel, Raman Bhai, Mathur Bhai, 2019. Supreme Court has held that per Mitaksha law of the succession, father self-acquired property given his son by way of will gift will remain the character of self-acquired property and will not become the ancestral property unless the contrary intention will be expressed in the testament. Radhamma versus State and Madhu Krishna and other 2019. Supreme Court held that undivided interest in the Hindu is a joint family property can dispose of the will according to the Section 30 of Hindu Succession Act 1956. Dudhamunipayya through LRs versus Munno Swami and others. Supreme Court has ruled that property inherited from the father by the son became joint family property in the hand of son. Rukhambai versus Lakshmi Minariya, AIR 1960. The normal state of every Hindu family is that it is a joint family property, presumable joint to the food. Worship and the state of it continues to be joint. Sitabai versus Ramchandra, AIR 1970. Even the death of the sole surviving co-partner of the Hindu joint family does not come to the end, so long as possible the law or nature to add a male members of it. K.O. Reddy versus Venkatya Reddy, AIR 1984. There is no presumption that the joint family possesses joint family. Commissioner of Income Tax versus Gomedal Lakshminarayan, AIR 1935. Property in the hand of sole survivor co-partner could be taxed as the Hindu undivided family. Krishna Prasad versus CIT Bangalore, AIR 1975. Joint family can consist of the male Hindu and his wife. It may be even consist of two female members, but there must be at least two members to constitute it. Makhan Singh versus Kulwant Singh, AIR 2007. DS Lakshmiya versus L. Babu Subramanyam, 2003. The property could not be presumed to be Hindu family property merely because the existence of the joint Hindu family. That one who assert his proof that property is a joint Hindu family property. Srimati Dippo versus Vasan Singh, AIR 1983. The property held by the sole surviving co-person may constitute his separate property on his death, and it will be derived by succession of the heir, and custom giving preference to the collateral will be void. Muktul versus Mannu Bhadi, AIR 1958. Supreme Court held that property inherited by a person from his mental grandfather is not an ancestral qua of his defendant. Arunachalmal versus Maruganthal, AIR 1953. Mitaksha father is competent to sale of his self-acquired property with the stranger without concurrence of his son. He is also make a gift of the property to one of his son to the determinant to the another. In such case, it is possible to hold that such property bequeaths the gift much necessary rank of ancestral property. Tirbhuvan Das versus Gujarat Revenue Tribunal, 1991. Youngest member of the joint Hindu family property can deal with the joint family property as a manager of the following circumstances. If the senior member of the Karta is not available, where the Karta relinquishes his right express and impliedly, the exceptional of the extraordinary circumstances affecting the whole family. Rani versus Sanatha, 1971 सुप्रीम कोर्ट 1971 फॉर एलिनेशन ऑफ द हिंदू जॉइंट फैमिली प्रॉपर्टी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लीगल नेसेसिटी सच नेसेसिटी इज नॉट ए सोल टेस्ट बट प्रेशर अपॉन द स्टेट मे बी रिगार्डेड एज अ सीरियस सफिशियंट बालमकुंड वर्सेस कमलावती AIR 1964 व्हेन द एलिगेशन ऑफ जॉइंट फैमिली प्रॉपर्टी बाय द कर्ता वाज नॉट फॉर लीगल नेसेसिटी द बेनिफिट इज सेड टू बी एलिनेशन इज वॉइडेबल एट द इंस्टेंस ऑफ अदर को पार्टनर।